Hi, I'm Chris Breen, and I spent the day at Apple's special Let's Rock event here in San Francisco. And as anticipated, it was all about iPods. Apple introduced two new spiffy iPods and maintained another iPod and sort of basically updated a final iPod. And the way that works out is this. They have the new iPod Touch, and the iPod Touch has some new features. Specifically, it has volume controls on the side. It also has a built-in speaker now, much like the iPhone. And then there's the new iPod 4G for fourth generation Nano. It now comes in 9 separate colors, very much like a rainbow pattern, except pink is technically not in the rainbow. And then there's the iPod Shuffle, has the same 5 colors, except they are now, according to Apple, more vibrant. So they use the same cans of paint that they use for these, now more vibrant colors. And there's also the iPod Classic, which now comes in one size only, which is 120 gigabytes. And we'll start with the iPod Touch, the new one. As I said, it has a built-in speaker. It also has volume controls on the side. And as I hold it to the side, you'll also see that the new Touch is very thin. The other Touch was pretty thin, and this is even thinner. It goes along with Apple's design ethic, meaning that it has rounded sides, much like the current iPhone does. This comes in 3 capacities and prices. It comes, the base model is 8 gigabytes, and that's $229. There's a 16 gigabyte model that is $299, and finally there's the 32 gigabyte model, which is $399. And here we have the 4G Nano. As I said, it comes in 9 different colors. This is the blue one. One of the important things about the new Nano is that you can now turn it on its side. It has an accelerometer built in, much like the iPhone and the iPod Touch. And what this brings you is now when you show a video on your iPod Nano, you can see it. It will automatically appear in a sideways view. Use the scroll wheel to move through, like in CoverFlow, as you do on your Mac or as you do within iTunes. And one other feature worth noting is the shake factor. This is sort of the really cool feature about the accelerometer, which is, let's say you're listening to a track and you say, I really don't want to hear this right now. I'd like to listen to anything else that happens to be on my iPod. All you have to do is give it a vigorous shake and it will automatically skip to another track that it picks at random. At the same time today, Apple also introduced a new version of iTunes, and that's iTunes 8. It has a couple of cool features, and one of them is Genius. And the way Genius works is this. You're working on your computer within your iTunes library. You're listening to a song and say, gosh, I really like that song. I don't really want to listen to the rest of the album. I'd like to listen to music that's kind of related to this or that goes well with this music. So let's say I pick an Elvis Costello track, for example. I can volunteer the contents of my library to Apple so that all the data in there is anonymously sent to Apple. Lots and lots and lots of other people have done the same thing. What happens is I say, select Elvis Costello, I push the Genius button, and off into the ether goes my request to the cloud where all this related information is. iTunes will look at that, it will say, you know, people who listen to this song also really like these songs. It then looks at the contents of my iTunes library and says, oh, you have these 25 songs that would go beautifully with this. So I show up with a Genius playlist that maybe includes Nick Lowe and Dave Edmonds, maybe Carlene Carter because Nick was married. And I get this nice playlist that is related. It's a wonderful way to discover new music. One of the things in iTunes 8 that's new is that you can now get HD television shows. So NBC shows, Showtime is represented as well, as is ABC. When you do that, you will download, actually you've purchased these things, you download the things, and when you do it, you also get iPod compatible versions of this video as well, because HD will not play on one of these devices, but you can get the smaller version that will play beautifully on it. So you get 2 versions, essentially for the price of 1, which is $2.99 per TV episode. So how important an event was this? Well, for Apple, it's very important because it's September. They're looking down the road at the holidays, and they would like it if you would buy tons of iPods for your nearest and dearest. But how about for you? If you have a really old iPod, it does make sense to upgrade. For example, if you have an old iPod Nano, it really is nice to be able to turn the iPod on its side and watch Lawrence of Arabia in this widescreen view instead of like this until your head explodes. If you have a more recent iPod, it's up to you. Maybe you want to collect them all. By all means, go out and buy all 9 colors of the Nano. But if you have an iPod Touch, yes, it's nice to have those external volume controls and a speaker. But beyond that, it doesn't make a whole lot of sense to upgrade. Of course, if you're purchasing a gift for somebody, any one of the iPods will be welcome. Thanks for watching. I'm Chris Breen.